Hello students, I am Kavita Singh from Samarpan Gyan School and today we will learn here 8th standard science chapter number 1 crop production and management. In a previous class we learn about the crops and soil preparation. Now here we will learn about sowing. What is sowing? Sowing means to plant seed in the ground. Okay, sowing means to plant seed in the ground. Okay, sowing, but remember one thing, seed should be sown at the right depth. Okay, right depth and proper distance. Okay, equal spacing. If the seeds are sown too deep in the soil, they may not germinate. Or if seeds get not covered by soil, if after sowing, if the seeds are not covered by the soil, if maybe damage caused by bird, insect or rat. Okay, so we remember that thing when we sow the seeds in the proper depth, with the proper depth and equal spacing, and cover with the soil also. Okay, now before sowing, do one thing, that is the seed selection. Why seed selection is important? Because good seeds give us a healthy crops and high yield. Okay, so always farmers did these things. They can select the good seeds. Okay, but what is the method of select the good seed? Take a seeds in a one vessels and pour water in it, and after some time you can observe that some seeds are float on the upper layer of water and some are settled down. Okay, some are float in the water. You can see here a full bucket of water and here seeds are float upper in the upper layer. So these floated seeds are hollow. Okay, hollow seeds are there, they are damaged seeds. So damaged seeds become hollow, are thus lighter. Such seeds float over water. Such seeds should be used for sowing. Okay, so such seeds are should not be used for sowing. These floating seeds are not for the sowing, because these seeds are hollow and lighter, and that means this is the damage. And heavier seeds are settled down, means good quality of seeds are settled down at the bottom of bucket. So use always good seeds, not floated seeds. Now here you can see the tools of sowing and methods also of sowing. You can see here two methods. That first one is the traditional method. This one is the traditional method and this is the modern, means it is used nowadays. So in traditional method you can see the method use seed sowing a funnel attached. You can see here funnel attached. Okay, funnel attached two or three pipes having sharp end. Two or three here pipes are attached with the sharp end. Pre-soil is used. Okay, so you can see here one funnel and two or three pipes are attached with the soil, sharp end is with the soil. So these are the traditional method, and one method is also, that is the scattering of seeds. Scattering means we can take a seeds our hand and scatter them in the soil. So it is also traditional method. Now here you can see the seed drill. This tool is called a seed drill, and nowadays the seed drills is used for the sowing with the help of tractor. These tools sows the seeds, unfortunately, proper distance and depth. Okay, you can see easily in the diagram these tools are going inside of the soil, right? So these tools are used for sowing, and nowadays we use the seed drills. Okay, now here you can see the adding manure and fertilizer. This is the next steps of agriculture practices. Adding manure and fertilizers are substances which are added to the soil to increase the fertility. okay, increase the fertility. When we want to increase our plants, they can good, if we want good plants, then we add the manure and fertilizer. But what is the manure and fertilizer? Fertilizer means, fertilizers are chemical substance. You can see here in this diagram, this is the fertilizer. Fertilizers are chemical substance which are rich in particular nutrient. They are produced in the factories. Example, urea, ammonia. And one thing is NPK. What is NPK? NPK. What is NPK? N means nitrogen, P for phosphorus, and K for potassium. Okay, so NPK means nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. Okay, any many fertilizers are available in the market. And in the second hand you can see the manure. Manure is an organic substance obtained from the decomposition of plant or animal waste. Okay, so this is the fertilizer and this is the manure, is the organic. Okay, and this is the chemical substance. Fertilizers are chemical and manures are the organic substance. Now see here, this is the difference between manure and fertilizer, right? Fertilizer is a man-made inorganic. It is a inorganic, means chemical substance. And manure is a natural substance obtained by decomposing of cattle dung or and a plant reduces. So it is a organic. Okay, fertilizers are inorganic and this is the organic or a natural substance. Fertilizers are prepared in the factories. Okay, and manure can be prepared in the field, means it is done in our fields or in a farm. Okay, but fertilizers want factories. Fertilizers not provided by humus to the soil, it not provide the humus to soil, but manures provide lots of humus to the soil. And fertilizers are very rich plant nutrition like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, etc. Manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrition. So this is the difference between fertilizer and manure. Okay, apart from adding fertilizer or manure, some other methods are also used for improve the soil fertility. Okay, which are they? For example, crop rotation. Okay, what is crop rotation? Growing different crop. You can see your on your screen, here is the maize and here is the paddy, or any other plant like vegetables plant, pulses plants, and rice plants, wheats plants, and etc. So growing different crop alternately, it is called the crop rotation. Okay, growing different crop alternately, it is called crop rotation. Okay, grown legume crop as a fodder in one season. For example, grown legume crops, a legume crop is pulses crop, like gram, tuer, and etc. Grow legume as fodder in one season and weed in the next season. Okay, first you grow the legume crop, then you grow the rice and wheat and etc. paddy or wheat, and next season again you can change your plant crop. That is help in the replenish of the soil with the nitrogen. Okay, so this is also help to use to improve the soil fertility. So today's our topic is finished here. We will meet into the next class.